Hello, I'm Pratibha Reddy, Assistant Professor, Department of ENTC, GH Raisoni Institute of Engineering and Technology, Pune. I'm going to discuss briefly about microcontroller. What is microcontroller? A microcontroller has a CPU in addition to a fixed amount of RAM, ROM, input-output ports, and a timer all on a single chip. In other words, the processor, RAM, ROM, I/O ports, and timer are all embedded together on one chip. Therefore, the designer cannot add any external memory, input, output, or timer to it. The fixed amount of on-chip ROM, RAM, and a number of input-output ports in microcontroller makes them ideal for many applications in which cost and space are critical. In many applications, for example, a TV remote control, there is no need for the computing power of a 486 or even an 8086 microprocessor. In many applications, the space it takes, the power it consumes, and the price per unit are much more critical considerations than the computing power. These applications most often require some input-output operations to read signals and turn on and off certain bits. So for this, it is interesting to note that some microcontroller manufacturers have gone as far as integrating an analog to digital converter and other peripherals into the microcontroller. So we can say that microcontroller means processor, memory, I/O, peripherals, and bus all are fabricated in a single IC. Let us discuss the differences between microprocessor and microcontroller. What is the difference between a microprocessor and microcontroller? This question comes always. By microprocessor is meant the general purpose microprocessors such as Intel's 8086 family or Motorola's 680X0 family. These microprocessors contain no RAM, no ROM, and no input-output ports on the chip itself. For this reason, they are commonly referred to as general purpose microprocessors. Let us go here we will analyze the differences between microprocessor and microcontrollers. Simple CPU itself is a microprocessor, whereas microcontroller contains ROM, RAM, I/O, and other peripheral devices fabricated in a single IC. So we can say this is the main difference between microprocessor and microcontroller. If you go with a few feature differences between microprocessor and microcontroller, several instructions for moving data from external memory to CPU in microprocessor. Microcontroller, only one or two instructions for moving the data from external memory to CPU. In microprocessor, few pins are malfunctioned. In microcontroller, large number of pins are malfunctioned. Microprocessor, program memory and data memory are same. Microcontroller uses different program memory and data memory. Again, to make this concept clear, we can say that we have to refer to Harvard architecture and von Neumann architecture, where in von Neumann architecture, program memory and data memory both are same, and whereas in Harvard architecture, it uses different program memory and data memory. And in microprocessor, it uses different ICs for memory and I/O. Because simple CPU, we are calling it as a microprocessor. So we have to interface all the input-output devices, memory, and other peripherals externally. Whereas in microcontroller, it is all, everything is fabricated, inbuilt in a single IC. And no inbuilt timers in microprocessor, and whereas inbuilt timers are there in microcontroller. So now let us discuss about the features of 8051 microcontroller. So coming to the very important point, it provides many functions, as we have already discussed the main difference, what is processor and controller. Now we are going to discuss about the features of 8051 microcontroller. It contains CPU, RAM, ROM, I/O, interrupt logic, timer, etc. in a single package. And the 8051 microcontroller is limited to 8-bit. because the size of the database is 8 bit, it can access 8 bits of data in one operation. Hence, it is an 8-bit microprocessor. And the size of the address bus is of 16 bit. And from this, we can calculate the total memory of 8051 microcontroller, which is 64 KB, which includes both RAM and ROM. And on-chip RAM is 128 bytes, which we will call it as data memory. On-chip ROM is 4 KB, which we will call it as program memory. And it contains four ports, P0, P1, P2, and P3. All four ports are of 8 bits. And all four ports are used as bidirectional input-output port. And it contains one serial port, UART, Universal Asynchronous Reception and Transmission. And it contains two inbuilt timers, which is of 16-bit, timer 0 and timer 1. And it contains two-level interrupt priority and power-saving modes. All together, we can design the microcontroller 8051. Coming to the architecture itself gives the better information how it is designed. So it contains two timers, timer 0, timer 1, about RAM and ROM. ROM is of 4K, RAM is of 128 bytes, and interrupt control, CPU, and it has oscillator, crystal oscillator, bus control, and it has four input-output ports, P0, P1, P2, and P3, and all four ports are used as a bidirectional input-output. And as we have already studied, the very important feature of 8051 microcontroller is it is having UART, Universal Asynchronous Reception and Transmission, and which contains two pins. One is for transmitting the data and another one is for reception of data. So this is a simplified block diagram of 8051 microcontroller. Let's discuss one by one in detail. First part, coming to the pin description of 8051 microcontroller, as we have already discussed, we have four ports, P0, P1, P2, and P3, and all four ports are used as bidirectional input-output ports. So now let us discuss about the four ports. First, we have a P1 port, which contains 8 pins P10 to P17. This port is used as a bidirectional input-output port and it is not having any other multiple functions. Coming to port 3 is used as a bidirectional input-output, as well as it is having the multiple functions like RxD, reception of data and transmission of data. This too belongs to the UART, serial communication. Then it contains two external interrupts, INT0 and INT1. Port 3, 4th and 5th pin contains the two timers, which is of 16-bit, timer 0 and timer 1. Coming to port 3, 6th pin and 7th pin are used for writing the data and reading the data. So we can say that port 3 is handling so many functions. And coming to port 0, as we have already discussed, that the size of the address bus is of 16 bit and size of the data bus is of 8 bit. And port 0 contains the multiplexing of lower byte of address bus and data bus, AD0 to AD7. Coming to port 2, it contains the higher byte of the address bus, A8 to A15. So this is the in detail architecture, how it works. And as we have already discussed, so these are the pin functions and the alternate function of the port 3, what it is performing.